Hello, hello! So this will be the last part of this series of sculpting a full male character. Now let's work on the feet. It can get a little slow, so I disable mirror modifier on the viewport first. Then go to bottom view and make the foot straight. Then go to its lateral side, and I'll just move the lateral ankle a bit forward. So divide this into three. And this right here is where the pinky toe starts. Then create a curve, and this is where the other toes start. Then I use lasso trim to trim this. I just shape this a bit so I can fit the toes later. Then I just define the planes for the top of the foot. I add a cube and shape it for the big toe. Then another cube for the second toe. Just remember that the length of the second toe varies, but here I'm just making it the longest, just like on what we normally see on anatomy books or sculptures. Notice how the toe has a stair-step shape and an arch below. I duplicate this for the other three toes. I bring each toe down to look like it's descending from the front view. Then repeat the stair step and arch for the big toe. Then I continue to move this so the toes will fit once I join them. On the bottom view, the toes should appear shorter, so I push this forward. Then I select all, convert to mesh, and join. Remesh and I start it smooth while shaping the foot. I define the planes on the toes more by creasing and scraping. These are all fat pads, so I inflate these. I'm just making the spaces between the toes more defined. Halfway here is a bump from the pinky's metatarsal. This is an important landmark for the lower feet's peroneals. Then here's a visible bump from the extensor digitorum brevis. Here are the tendons of the extensor digitorum longus where it go down to each toe except the big toe. Then here's a tendon from the extensor hallucis longus for the big toe. Then the tendon from the tibialis anterior. The foot has an arch here, so just push this in. Then these are just fat pads. Try trimming this and you'll see what the footprint will look like. It's also a great way to check the arches or what touches the ground. I masked the nails and used Draw Sharp on the edges to define it. I masked the foot and smooth mask a couple times. Go to bottom view and use transform to rotate and move the foot. Then make sure to check and fix some areas affected by the transform. Here I'm just doing some minor edits. I lower the voxel size to get a cleaner look. I inflate the sides on the joint area to give it more shape, and not just a straight boring toe from the top. Make the four toes facing downward more. Then the big toe's tip facing up. Then here, I define the tendons more. Now it's time to join all the parts. But first, I spread his legs, so that we keep them separated even after remeshing. And just keep checking things that can be improved. Now select all and convert to mesh to apply the mirror modifier on the legs. Then join. Remesh and smooth these hard creases from the different parts. Then feel free to add more details to your character, such as veins, scars, but I'll just leave this be and call this done. So thank you all for following this series. That's all. Happy sculpting. Bye.